In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make the technique of the C2C, the corner to corner, changing color, to follow a chart of squares to make blankets, bags, pillows, or whatever you want. You can use any pattern of the C2C technique. You can use a cross stitch pattern, any pattern that uses squares to make the picture. You have to make a sample to know how many inches, how many centimeters is every block. In my case, using a 3.5 or 4 millimeters crochet, I'm making blocks of 1 centimeter per 1 centimeter. So making this pattern of 13 per 13 squares, I will get a 13 per 13 centimeters sample. As I said, you can use any pattern with squares to make this technique. In this case, I printed an 80 per 100 squares pattern to make a lion. So you can use any kind of patterns that you have with squares. If I make this pattern, I will get an 80 centimeters per 100 centimeters, like a baby blanket, more or less. So let's go with a step by step to change the color. I will explain also how to make the C2C technique. This is a pattern of the sample that you can find in my website. The corner to corner is a technique that you start from one corner and you finish on the other corner. You will start from here, from this corner. It's useful to draw arrows to make which is the direction that you have to follow making the squares. Start with a slip knot and you have to chain 6. Chain 3. Mark with the finger the third chain and chain 3 again. You have to make one double crochet on the third chain. And one double crochet on the second and on the first chain. So 3 double crochet. This is the first block, the first square. Now we have to make the second row. We made the first row, so the second row you have to make to the other side, two blocks, two squares to the other side. Start the row number 2 with chain 6. You have to make chain 3, mark with the finger, chain 3 again, and one double crochet on the chain. One double crochet on the third chain and on the second and the first chain. You have to make 3 double crochet. Then you have to turn the first square on the wrong side of the double crochet. You have to make one slip stitch between the chain 3 and the double crochet. Here you have to make one slip stitch. Then you have to chain 3 and make 3 double crochet in the space between the chain 3 and the double crochet. 3 double crochet. And you made the second block. You have to start the third row from here to the top, to this direction. And the fourth row from here and make 4 stitches to this direction. And the row number 5, 5 stitches with the base color to the top, to this direction. You have to continue making the increases as I will explain you to have the five blocks of the base color. How to make the increases? You have to chain 6. One double crochet on the chain number 3, 2 and 1. And you have to make a slip stitch in the space in between the chain 3 and the double crochet of the previous row. Start with chain 3 and make 3 double crochet in the same space of the slip stitch. Make again 1 slip stitch, chain 3 and 3 double crochet. You have now the third row with 3 blocks. Continue making the increases to have 5 blocks. Once you finish the row number 5, you have to start the row number 6 to this direction. You have to make 4 stitches, 4 blocks with the base color, 1 in brown and 1 with the base color. So start with the increase, making the chain 6, the 3 double crochets, slip stitch, chain 3, 3 double crochet, continue making to have 4 stitches with the base color. Once we are at the end of the 4th block, you don't have to finish the 3rd double crochet. You have to finish the 3rd double crochet using the new color. In this case it's the brown color, so take the brown yarn, close the 3rd double crochet with the brown yarn, pull the blue yarn and make the slip stitch in the following block with the brown yarn. Then you have to make 1 block in brown, so chain 3 and make 3 double crochet. In this case we have to make the last block in the with the base color, so we have to finish the 3rd double crochet with the base color. In my case I will use another ball of yarn of the base color because I will separate the 2 parts of the pattern. I will separate both parts with 2 different balls of yarn. It will be better for the ends of the yarn. So take the new ball of yarn and make the last block with the blue yarn, with the base color. You have to start the row number 7 to this direction, 1 in the base color, 3 in brown and 3 with the base color. So start with the first square, chain 6, 3 double crochet on the chain 3, 2 and 1, and you have to finish the 3rd double crochet with the brown color. You have to pull a little bit the yarn and close the last double crochet with the brown yarn. Then you have to make the slip stitch also with the brown yarn and make now 3 blocks with the brown yarn. Make 3 blocks in brown. Once you made the second block, you find here the blue yarn of the second ball. We don't need this yarn now, so we have to place the yarn to the back and make the stitches around this yarn. So make the slip stitch. Chain 3 and make the 3 double crochet around the blue yarn. On the 3rd double crochet of the block, you have to change the color and take the blue yarn and finish this row with all the blocks in blue. On the row number 8, we have to make 3 blocks with the base color, 4 with the brown yarn and 1 with the base color. So start with the chain 6 and make 3 blocks in blue, 3 blocks in the base color. Finish the 3rd double crochet of the 3rd block with the brown yarn. Pull the blue yarn and make the slip stitch in brown. Make now 4 blocks with the brown yarn, 4 blocks with the brown yarn. Once we have the last stitch in brown, we have to close the last double crochet with the base color. Remember taking the other ball of yarn. So close the 3rd double crochet, make the slip stitch and make the last block with the blue yarn, with the base color. We finish the row number 8. Row number 9. 1 with the base color, 4 in brown and 4 with the base color. You have to continue increasing, changing the color as I explained. You have to place the green yarn in the row number 10 and remember changing the color as I explained. You have to continue making increases to the row number 13. Once you are at the row number 13, you have to start decreasing. I finished the row number 13 and now I have to start making decreases and I have to make the stitches to this direction. You have to make 2 blocks with the base yarn, 6 with the green yarn, 1 in brown and 3 with the base color. How we have to make the decreases? You have to turn, you don't have to chain 6 now, you have to turn and make 1 slip stitch on the next 3 stitches. You have to slip to the end of this block, 3 slip stitches, make 1 slip stitch in between the chain 3 and the double crochet and make this block. In this case I have to make this block with the blue yarn. So chain 3 and make 3 double crochet to make the block. One slip stitch with the next block. Make the second block in blue. We have to change the color, so we have to take the green yarn and finish the 3rd double crochet of the second block with the green yarn and continue making the green blocks and the brown block, changing the color as I explained. Here you can see that you made the first decrease. So making decreases in all the rows, you will close the square. How we have to make the last stitch? We make the third block, we make the last block in blue, the third block in blue of the end of the row, make chain three, the three double crochet, and make the slip stitch. We don't have to make another block now, we have to turn and make again the three slip stitches to the top of this block. Make the last slip stitch between the chain three and the double crochet and start the next row, making a block, chain three, three double crochet, you can see here another decrease. You have to continue making the blocks, changing the colors, and once you made the last block, you don't have to continue making the chain six, you have to make a slip stitch as we made before, making the decrease. Continue making decreases to close the square. I made the two blocks, so make the slip stitch, turn, slip to the chain three space. We have to make three slip stitches to the chain three space, chain three, and three double crochet to finish the last block. Make a slip stitch and cut the yarn. And this is the way to change the color when you are making the C2C technique. You learned now how to change the color with this technique.